Hey everyone, KibbyKing77 here from the AC Syndicate team, here to do a full review video of the Odext Blue ROM on my Sprint Samsung Galaxy S3. Very excited to show off this ROM. I've been running it pretty much all day today. I flashed it yesterday, which is actually when I made the how-to video, which I do have, I can link to if you guys want to know how to install it. So you can check that out. But anyways, if you guys had an Epic 4G Touch, you are familiar with this ROM. Because he made one of these ROMs for the Epic 4G Touch. It was great. But anyways, this is definitely a blue-themed ROM, courtesy of Strong Steve. He always likes to make his ROMs Odext, which is, there's Dedext and Odext. Some claim Dedext is faster, some claim Odext is faster. I don't really want to get into the argument, but anyways, it's actually more difficult to edit and theme Odext ROMs, so shout out to him for doing that. Anyways, let's go ahead and get into it. Settings, scroll down, about device, and we are on Android 4.0.4, and we are on Strong Steve Odext Blue right there, 1.1, LG8. It is based off the latest over-the-air update, LG8. It is a TouchWiz-based ROM. You'll see right away you got some awesome blue overscroll glow, nice blue settings icons right over there. You'll see he does a great job at theming his ROMs. This background is actually a custom background sent to me by a good friend, Ann-Am. He has made it for me. You'll see it's a custom KibbyKing77 background. Obviously, you're not going to have this when you install. It's actually some other blue background. But anyways, lock screen-wise, you pretty much have the stock lock screen. You can customize shortcuts, etc. Launcher, you do have, I believe it is Apex Launcher. And Nova Launcher. Sorry about that, guys. You have Nova Launcher, which is very smooth. He did a great job at making this ROM extremely smooth. I really get no lag whatsoever. Gmail application is themed. You'll see black and blue right there. I mean, obviously, if you're not a fan of blue, you might not want to install this ROM. So you'll see got all my nice YouTube comments. A little behind on the comments, 248. Should get to some of those tonight. Anyways, though, up at the top, let's go ahead and check out that status bar. Right there, nice blue clock. You have a nice blue battery icon. There's actually a mod for a different battery icon if you don't like this one in the original post of the thread. So I can link, well, obviously I'll link to that for you guys. So just what you can do is just flash it, install it through Clockwork Mod. You can wipe cache and Dalvik cache before you install it and you'll be good. So you can do that if you'd like. I'll actually probably do that after I make this video. Nice blue signal bars, nice blue Wi-Fi icon along with more blue icons up there. Go ahead and pull down the notification bar. You'll see, obviously blue, more blue. You'll see some nice blue icons up there when selected. The brightness bar here is blue as well. You got the nice Android guy down there going on. It is semi-transparent. You can kind of see through it, but not really. So overall, a very nice, clean-themed notification bar there. Other than that, though, I mean, you'll have app icons themed. You'll see calculator. I think that you see that's themed a little bit. Calendar, camera icon is themed. You'll see some of the icons down here are themed as well. Let me go ahead and switch there. And there we go. So you'll see the button there is themed blue. Other things, gallery, the icons theme, internet browser. It's a stock browser, but it has a themed the themed icon right there to look like the AOSP style. Gmail icon's obviously themed. Of course, messaging icon is themed. The Play Store, actually, he changed it to say the market, so get a little nostalgia going if you remember when it was called the Android Market, which wasn't too long ago, so I hope you'd remember. The stock Samsung Music Player's icon is changed, so, I mean, it has a nice themed Wi-Fi tether application, too. You'll notice that. So overall, a very themed ROM, looks very great, the nice blue look to it. Dialer-wise, you have a great themed dialer. You'll see here, very cool. You can actually get some call recording while in a call. Let's go ahead and make a call. So you can see what it looks like in call. So you can hit record there. I think it records to your internal SD card, if I had to guess. I haven't tried it yet. But there you go. So there's your in-call screen right there. Very nice. Overall, great dialer, great theming there. The messaging application is themed, I believe, which it is. So let's go ahead and check it out. So you'll see I installed the Ice Cream Sandwich keyboard on my own. Let's go ahead and text Google and say, hey, the bubbles here are themed on your own, obviously, so you're gonna have to mess with those on your own. So otherwise, though, I mean, it's very quick. Trust me, it's a very smooth ROM. Everything has been very fluent and quick. I haven't had really any lag issues. Battery's been great as well. It's been a little bit better than stock, so that's what you go for in a ROM. You have the jelly, I believe you have the jelly bean animations. Let's go ahead. Not kind of. You have more ice cream sandwich animations, the stock animations pretty much. So you've got that going on. You have the 1X and 3G basically modifications. So when you actually get 1X speeds, it will switch to 1X. And when you get 3G speeds, it will go to 3G. So you'll see you got a nice blue 3G icon there up at the top. Lights up blue. Let's say I wanted to open up a web page, you'll see the icons light up blue as well. So very awesome, very nice theme work. I'm actually a fan of the blue, the nice, looks, give it an ACS blue look to it. But I'm actually a pretty big fan of it. It looks nice. You'll see pull down notifications. You got nice blue icons. I mean, everything looking that black and blue feel to it, which I like. Obviously, you might not be a fan, which is a personal opinion, of course. So again, I'm actually a fan of this ROM. I've been running it all day, as I said, and it's been very nice. So you're definitely gonna have to check it out. It, especially if you're looking for a stable ROM, this has no bugs whatsoever. Everything should work just fine. You remove some sounds, no camera sounds, no screenshot sounds at all. So you don't have to worry about those, thankfully. Anyways, that's really about it. That's all I wanted to show you guys, let you guys know about this awesome ROM, Odex Blue, courtesy of Strong Steve, so be sure to thank him. But again, I mean, flicking through all these pages, everything is very smooth, through your app drawer, through your widgets, through your pages, everything is very quick and snappy. So definitely check out the Odex Blue ROM, especially if you're a fan of blue. Press and hold the power button, you got some reboot options. If you hit restart, reboot, quick reboot, download, auto mode, and recovery. So you got some options there to go quickly into certain things, which is great. But other than that, though, you're definitely going to have to let me know what you think. If you like this blue, if you don't, what you think of the ROM, be sure to leave a comment. Be sure to subscribe as well. Follow me on Facebook, Twitter, and Google+. All links will be in the description of the video below. And as always, thanks for watching. Be sure to give this video a thumbs up.